Greetings everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today I wish to get nostalgic once more as I cover a character arc from one of my favorite video games, the Freedom Force franchise. Now, this game franchise is an underrated gem in the world of gaming, it having been written by one of the individuals who worked on the BioShock series, you could expect a great narrative, and Freedom Force does not disappoint. Now, some of you might think Freedom Force is just an Avengers or Justice League knockoff, given the amount of tropes there are, but it's more than that. It's a colorful, fun world of political ideologies and deep story arcs. But Freedom Force versus the Third Reich made the Alchemiss, Catherine Larchmont Price's story, great. Now, Alchemiss, by first blush, could be viewed as a love child of Jean Grey and Rogue from the X-Men, two powerhouses in Marvel due to her red hair and southern charm. But Alchemiss is a character who goes beyond those tropes and is truly her own character. When we view Catherine Larchmont Price's origin, we view a vain college student with very little interest in others' religious beliefs, but that changes for her once her DNA mutates with Energy X, the power source that gives Freedom Force their powers and a statue of a mystical goddess known as the Alchemiss. And this ends up saving her life when a drunken college classmate arrives at her dorm with every intent to assault her. If this game weren't made for kids, this could be construed as an attempted rape. Luckily for Catherine, the goddess's powers kick in, ultimately protecting her. I'll let this moment play out for you so you can get the full context.
Catherine Larchmont Price, the most popular and beautiful girl at City University.
Hey, Catherine, how about a date?
Gorgeous, wait up.
What a knockout.
Come on, dollface. Won't you let me take you out tonight?
I'd love to, boys, but my allergies are killing me.
What could a sweet thing like you be allergic to?
Me.
Oh, come on, darling.
Oh, wise goddess of the ages, help me see the way. Guide me to righteousness, lead me out of darkness.
Oh, wise goddess of the east, help me see the way. Why is my roommate the most unpopular girl in school?
And if you will roommate, but the goddess is as old as time herself.
Well, Emily, that goddess of yours must look a horrible fright.
Panacea, Catherine, you want powers you do not understand.
Later that night.
That silly goose. If she thought less about the goddess and more about the homecoming dance, she wouldn't be such a awful bore.
Suddenly, a strange light enters Catherine's room. Or perhaps just her dreams, and in its purple glow, the image of the goddess appears.
My spirit is entering your world's wish, girl. Like an alchemist converts base metals into gold, you will use my powers to go wrong into right.
What a bizarre dream. How did that revolting statue end up in my hands? And why is it glowing so horribly?
Who could that be?
It's me, 3 in the morning. You again? My goodness, you smell as if you've just come from some degenerate roadhouse.
Hey, sweetheart, I just wanted a little kiss tonight.
You hurting me!
Now, don't be like that, darling.
Unhand me! Oh my, I foolishly believed the goddess was just so much nonsense. But it was her powers that protected me from that revolting brute. She told me I should convert wrong into right. Such will be the work of the Alchemiss.
Now, with Alchemiss's arc in the first game, I'll have to get into some light spoilers, but all I'll reveal is she forges a romance with her teammate, Manbot. This love runs deep on her part, in fact, so deep that when Manbot sacrifices himself for the greater good at the end of the first game, Alchemiss just can't move on, and how could she? She's devastated by her lover being trapped in the celestial clock, so much so that once Versus the Third Reich opens, it begins her greatest character arc of all time. It starts with her having a terrible dream, which is half nightmare, half psychic vision, where her worst fears are revealed. She's terrified of being betrayed by her friends, and above all, she's terrified that she'll never be reunited with Manbot ever again. And throughout, we see shades of that. We see Alchemiss beginning to tap further into her mystical powers, albeit at first to bring back her teammate Bullet, who is stuck in the World War II timeline. But once she gets a taste of that power, she begins using it more and more, simply because it feels good. It gets to a point where she frees Manbot, but this leads to Alchemiss having her huge Dark Phoenix moment, where she becomes Entropy. And as Entropy, she suffers through dissociative identity disorder while also drunk off this cosmic power. But Alchemiss's arc ends in quite a shocking, yet very satisfying way. For those of you who have never played, all I'll say is her story ends with sacrifice and a major cliffhanger that never got fully resolved due to this series not being made into a trilogy. Freedom Force is truly the thesis for real great character arcs, and Alchemiss is by far, in my opinion, is the greatest. For those of you who haven't played, I cannot recommend it enough. You can find it on GOG and Steam, both of which I'll link down below. Thank you all for watching, subscribe to the channel, God bless, happy viewing, and have a nice night.